In this video, I'm going to talk about a problem I've heard many New Zealand garages complain about, a shortage of technicians. I think that if you understand why there's a shortage, you've got a better chance of doing something about it. So here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to show you some data that shows why there's a shortage of automotive technicians in New Zealand, which, to be honest, is probably similar to data in many other countries. Then I'm going to tell you what you can do about the shortage. Spoiler alert, there's nothing you can do about it. Immigration, education, and market competition are all factors out of your control. So the only thing that you can really do is look after the technicians you already have. Let's get into it. The first reason there's a tech shortage is competition. The number of automotive repair and maintenance enterprises in New Zealand has been increasing steadily over the past few years. Just in the past 10 years, the number of garages has grown by 15%. If you look at that from a regional perspective, you've got over 2,500 garages in Auckland all competing for technicians. But for smaller centres like Gisborne or the West Coast, where it's harder to attract new staff, the battle for technicians is going to be even fiercer. Now, in contrast to the increase in new garages, the number of cars for them to repair is decreasing. Car and motorcycle registrations have been on the decline for several years, and they're likely to dip even more with the ending of the EV and hybrid incentives. So, there are less cars, but more garages to work on them, so competition is obviously going to increase. At the same time, the market share of EVs and hybrids has increased from 4% to 14% over the past 2 years. Even with the removal of incentives, it's a foregone conclusion that electrification is going to increase, and technicians who are trained in that technology will be in high demand. It's stating the obvious, but the number of new technicians entering the market isn't meeting demand. Proof of this is here, on the Immigration New Zealand website. The green list is a list of professions where there aren't enough New Zealanders to meet demand, and if a foreign citizen is qualified in that profession, they'll be fast-tracked to residency in New Zealand. Look here, diesel mechanics, motor mechanics, and motorcycle mechanics are all on the list. Now, you may ask, what about apprenticeships? Yes, the number of apprentices has slowly been increasing over the past 10 years, but stating the obvious again, there simply aren't enough to satisfy demand. And who knows what will happen to our vocational education system, which is being overhauled as we speak. Now, there was a huge increase in migration after the COVID-19 pandemic, and you could argue that caused a shortage in qualified staff in New Zealand. But in reality, the main reason for that was expats stuck in New Zealand returning to their own country. And you can see, migration is cyclic, so there's no point in getting hung up about it. There's nothing you can do about it. And a final factor making it harder to find good technicians today is the fact they are aging. The latest data available is from 2013, but this shows that 80% of all technicians were over the age of 40. 80%! Those guys are going to be very hard to uproot from their current jobs, and they are going to expect higher salaries. Although the auto repair industry in New Zealand is, for the most part, unregulated, some rules are starting to creep in. From 2027, technicians regassing air conditioning on cars will need to be certified, which will increase the demand for techs with that qualification. And although New Zealand hasn't actually started regulating work on EV high voltage systems, there are training courses available on how to fix them. So, for safety's sake, it makes sense that some sort of regulation will come in the future. As I said at the beginning, employers have very little influence over the reason for the technician shortage. There are more garages, but less techs and cars, so you're just going to have to fight harder to keep what you've got and try new ways to attract new technicians. I hope you found that useful. Please let me know in the comments if you have any opinions or questions. See you.